the River Rosara in Tuscany. Lightweight sketch pad. Still work in progress on my lightweight sketch pad. Still trying to work it out and trying to improve things. Anyway, let's see how we get on with the scene. River Rosara, looking to the sun. Nice leaves there coming across the above the river, creating a bit of contrast with the background trees. The light, a lot of light hitting the water. Lovely shaped boulders going up and down the left and the right of the stream, coming up to the foreground. Lots of different colours, warms, cools, lots of cools in that bamboo forest. The more sort of oak and bamboo in the background. Let's see how we get on. All right, step one, do the drawing and my lightweight sketch setup, easel setup. It's got this detachable board, which is made out of Corex, two pieces of Corex, and I've got a piece of Saunders paper about 8 inches by 6 inches. So let's get in the scene. Starting with those yellow leaves coming out from the right-hand side and the back of the river going over to the left. Now there's some lovely boulders in this river. Let's get in a few of them. And they're going to give a feeling of depth going into the distance with these succession of shapes going down that left-hand side. There's a nice boulder here catching the light. It's quite a big one. And then on the right-hand side, again, a succession of boulder shapes, one in front of the other. Not so big as the ones on the left. They're massive, some of those. Sky is going to be there. That's going to be quite bright in there. I think that's all we need to create the scene. Right, let's get painting. So attach that to that with these little bracket slotting in, and might just raise the camera a little bit so you can see what's going on. That's a little bit better. My Frank Herring palette filled with Mark Chapman's gouache paints, Academy Red, Hansa Yellow, Ultramarine Blue, white gouache down here. It's a neutral tint, that's a watercolour, there's a couple of watercolours in there, but mainly gouache. And let's get some water and some brushes. All right. So very bright in there. And this yellowy leaves, that brightly lit tree. Over the other side, darker, darker foliage. Use that blue, a little bit of yellow. Very dark over to the left, and then just coming down towards the river's edge, more of a cooler grey of these rocks and boulders. Feeling of some sunlight coming in there from the right. And water is going to be a brownish colour. So I use the red, the yellow, a little bit of blue. Soft edges, could be some pebbles under the water surface. Now cooler on the right hand side. Again, going a little bit darker on the left. A little bit of green. Some of the foliage coming out from the shadows, catching a little bit of light. All right, now for the boulders on that far side. They're going to be cooler and quite dark. Quite dark at the base of them where they meet the water. And there's catching a lot of light. Green moss on the far side. There's a little bit of green on some of these boulders. Right, different brush. Let's go with smaller synthetic brush, trying to get in some of the darker, oops, that's too dark, then some boulders on this left-hand side. The darker leaves over to the right. Bit of foliage coming up from the right hand side, connecting with the bank on the left. A different brush. Go with a little flat brush. And need to go a bit darker. Darker a bit darker on this left hand side. It's just a case of applying these different layers and trying to capture the essence of that, the texture of the rocks. Let's go down to the right. It gets a bit more sort of steamy. So. Bit of white gouache with some ultramarine blue. I think I need to go a bit darker in this bottom right corner. Some of those leaves. That's wrong brush for that. Back to a little, goes my little synthetic brush. To get a bright yellow. Those leaves that are catching the light. It's a bit of white gouache with this Hansa yellow. All right, back to, let's have a little flat brush. Little flat brush. And get in on that far side. And some cooler shadow. Ultramarine blue. White gouache. Definition to some of the pebbles on this side. think I'm nearly there. Might need to get a few darker stones, pebbles in the downstream here. Ultramarine blue, burnt sienna. A few little lines just to suggest the flow. River. I think I might need a little bit of highlighting on some of these rocks. So I need to get a good strong, just getting up some white gouache, and then just on some of the stones. Some foliage down the bottom right corner. Have I captured the essence of it? More rocks lurking in the farther side of that bank. Those leaves are bothering me. I need to adjust those a little bit. Bit of a darker, going really dark in the background. No neutral tint. Red sienna, ultramarine blue. And going really dark in there. Here we go. That rock there just needs a bit more definition. Here we are, a babbling brook in Tuscany on a lightweight homemade plein air setup and using half gouache, half watercolour paints from Mark Jarman's. Thanks for watching, catch up with you on the next one.